have the African subsidiaries impacted the fortunes of UB?
Given the benefit on hindsight, I am very glad that we did it. And not that UBA is one of the banks. UBA is the only bank in Nigeria that has footprints in so many countries. Today, we have in Africa, today we have footprints in 19 African countries, from East Africa to Central Africa to West Africa and so on. Of course, Nigeria remains our stronghold and so on. Why is it so? See, Africa remains a very, very attractive market. Apart from China and probably India and some few other Asian countries, Africa remains the second fastest growing region. The GDP for Africa has been far above that of the global average for some time. Apart from UBA Ghana, we started in 2005 as Standard Trust Bank Ghana. The next subsidiary was Cameroon. We started in 2008 after the merger between Standard Trust Bank and the old UBA and so on. So we started with almost nothing. By end of last year, 2015, the African countries have contributed 22% to our total group profit. And by end of first quarter this year, March 2016, the African countries have contributed 28%. And that is growing.
Before we talk about your retirement, you know, a CEO's personality tends to rub off on the corporate culture. How do people describe you? And how do you describe yourself?
How do I describe myself? UBA is not run by only one person. Yes, the CEO stands out, but we have a team. Our ESCO is made up of very strong people. And what we have done is, one, governance. Very, very key to us. No matter what we do, governance, you know, is the first that we look at. Two, we manage our risks very, very well. No matter how you look at it, we do not dabble into any kind of transaction anyhow. And three, we believe that the visibility is very, very key. And of course, as a CEO, you are the chief brand officer of the bank. And you need to make sure that the brand is not eroded in any form. And you need to send that signal, which is basically what I am doing. And most importantly, you need to network and meet with people. And that's the job of a CEO. You have to do that beyond just crunching the numbers and making sure that the bank runs very, very well.
You spent the last 28 years in the banking industry.
Yes.
And you'll be retiring soon.
That's right.
What will you be getting up to next?
I believe that I will still be around contributing to the development of the banking industry and the financial system as a whole. I don't know the nature of that contribution, but I know I will continue to contribute.
But you've had about a year to think about this retirement.
Yes. Working in a big place like UBA, I can tell you honestly, you are very, very busy. I have not started thinking of anything until when I sign off from UBA on Sunday, July 31st, 2016.
You have, by the grace of God, reason to be group CEO of a big bank like UBA. Yet, you started with a degree in civil engineering. You had a first class degree in civil engineering. You went on to get a master's degree in civil engineering. How did you make that crossover to banking?
Now, let me talk about the degree in engineering. And what that does for you is that it gives you a platform to think broad and do quite a whole lot of things and so on. Yes, when I started to do engineering, my whole objective was to be an engineer, building structures, building bridges, building infrastructures, roads, buildings, and so on and so forth. One of the things that generated interest, as far as I'm concerned, in banking is that need to have a diverse and broad knowledge and so on. I wanted to know everything about everything, if you like, and not just limit myself to technical competence in engineering. Accounting, I can talk about. Economics, I can talk about. Management, I can talk about. The economy, I can talk about. Manufacturing, I can talk about. And so on. Agriculture, I can talk about, because I finance all those things, and so on. So I am very, very glad that I've been able to acquire that knowledge of knowing so many things across the entire economy.
The Lord does indeed order our steps. Mr. Philip Odoza, we thank you for your time.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate it.
And we thank you for watching. Please join us next time when the program returns. But between now and then, do let us continue this conversation online at channelstv.com. And please follow me on Twitter at @modelesy. Tweet me your thoughts on my conversation with Mr. Odoza. Thank you again for watching, and see you soon.